Insperity presents the Small Business Advocate Show with Jim Blasingame, brought to you by FedEx, CareerBuilder.com, and Palo Alto Software. This is a copyrighted production of Small Business Network, Inc., all rights reserved.
Marshall Tucker bringing us back 17 till. I'm Jim Blasingame. Thanks for being part of my day. My website is smallbusinessadvocate.com. Please go there and use it to your advantage. We've got a lot of stuff there that will help you with your small business. Don't forget to check out the brand new video that we just posted this week and new poll question as well. If you haven't seen that, please go check that out and tell us what you think. And also, don't forget to subscribe to my free newsletter and check out all the other things, including the body of work that Tom Markel has deposited with us in the 5+ years he's been a member of our Brain Trust. And Tom is the founder of iBank.com, also the CEO and founder of Virtue Capital Corporation. And Tom, thanks again for hanging out with us. You were nice enough to relate to us your experience of being charged by a former so-called employee in the Department of Labor setting, and you talked to us about the things that you had to do to get ready for that, and tell the audience the resolution of that case. How did it turn out?
Well, we had put together a 3-ring binder, Jim, of every document, every email, the corporate formation documents, the licensing, so that when the judge was looking through the documents, they could see a very well organized,
right,
I dotted T.
You looked like you had your cornflakes together, didn't you?
We did, and the other guy, of course, brings a yellow folder, and it's just got papers everywhere, and he's trying to organize it, and he's looking through it, and ours was very succinct from the minute he opened the documents. There mm-hmm. was a tab by tab. Go to the red tab, sir, and look at our formation. Go to the blue tab, look at our licensing. Well, anyway, so the questions went back and forth, and she said to him, "Well, sir, it looks like you're an independent contractor of this company. You're not an employee, which is all the paychecks have been paid to you as a corporation. You have your own corporation here. You just handed me your corporate card. Sir, is there something I'm missing here?" excuse me, Jim. He said, "Well, I mean, I'm trying to argue the fact that he forced me to use my corporation and not be an employee." Mm-hmm. And she said, "Well, I'm sorry, sir, that's not this court. This court decides whether you were fairly paid or not."
Right.
And anyway, she said, "This case is closed. Thank you for coming, but we're not the right
court."
So
he can now take you to another court, though. So you jump that hurdle. And folks, this is the part. Tom's being gracious enough to share his experience with us, so we can kind of see what people have to go through when you have this kind of a charge brought against you. But so now he has another bite at the apple, doesn't he?
That's right. He can now take me and decide at another court whether he was an independent contractor or an employee. And there's several laws. We, about a year ago, partnered up with the IRS to help the IRS with small business issues on how to form corporations, how to tax the proper taxes, and issues related to independent contractor versus employee. And so, we use a third party firm help us do all of our bookkeeping and payroll and so on. And and I think over the years, and I want to talk about virtuous leadership, Jim, because it's one of our promises at iBank, becoming a member, is that it's the I, it's to inspire virtuous leadership. And I want to say that we've always, when an independent contractor was independent, we knew they were independent. When they were an employee, we paid them as an employee, even though you have taxes and all that mm-hmm. sort of thing to help. Government's not really doing much to help small business hire people. But anyway, you pay your taxes and you pay your fair share, and you do what's right. And I think you always get blessed with more business when you do the things that are right.
Is that part of what you call virtuous leadership?
I do. I think that, yeah, you pay your fair share of, if it's an independent contractor, of course, you don't have the matching,
right,
and you don't have the,
so you took
all
this,
that sort of thing.
You, so this charge brought against you, you felt was an insult to what you consider to be the way you treat people.
That's right. I mean, I and I and But there's an issue. My dad taught me. He says, you know, you can be greedy, Tom, or you can be stupid, but you can never be both greedy and stupid.
Yeah.
You know, and what that means is you're stealing money from other people. You can be greedy and go after as much greed as you want, and you can be stupid and lose your money. But when you get both, you end up stealing somebody's money, or you steal time, or you steal somebody's, you know, knowledge.
Which reminds me of one of my mentors told me, sometimes whenever you're deciding whether to go or no go on something, he said, ask yourself, do I have a fighting chance, or do I have just a chance to fight?
There you go.
And so this guy really just has a chance to fight, and that's the being greedy and stupid.
It was being greedy and stupid, and the point is that both these cases, in two cases in the 27 years I've run businesses and thousands of employees, in both cases I actually gave the gentleman more money than they deserved because I felt bad for them.
Right.
They needed to make more money. I handed this man almost $8,000 to help him in his life. And I helped another kid who was in his 20s. This guy's in his 50s. And I have that kind of soft Christian heart, you know, and it's always come back to hurt me, always. But I keep doing it. And these two guys sued me, even though I've given them more money than they deserved because they were on commission.
Yeah.
And we have the documents to show the commissions and the agreements through the emails back and forth. And instead of going out and getting a job, leaving this behind, it's about lawsuits. They take your brain energy. They take your anger. They just take a lot away.
Do you think there's more of that now than there used to be, Tom?
It must be. I mean, just because people, you get greedy.
But you know, Tom, I know that these aren't the only two people you've treated this way. You treat people like this all the time. So I don't, you know, I'm sure you're not going to get cynical about this. I mean, if you've had all the people who've worked with you and whom you've helped over the years, for only two to have done who have sued you, I think that's a pretty good track record myself. Folks, the main thing I wanted you to do was hear about Tom's experience and think about it for yourself. 10 till. We're going to come back and talk about some other things. Stay with us.
Insperity presents the Small Business Advocate Show with Jim Blasingame, brought to you by FedEx, CareerBuilder.com, and Palo Alto Software. This is a copyrighted production of Small Business Network, Inc., intended for the private use of our audience. Except as otherwise provided by copyright law, all other copying, redistribution, or publication without prior written consent is prohibited. All rights reserved.